How'd you feel when Norm passed away?
That was a bummer because he was, you know, what, 61? And I just didn't see it coming. And I've watched so many hours of his stuff. And I've met him, and he was like this comedic bar. Like, hey, we got Norm, you know? There's so much shit comedy. Then you see Norm, and you're like, this is next level. This is savant-type shit. And then to lose him is like, ah! Norm had 20 more years at least of just content and thoughts and his point of view, and that's, we'll never get that, and that sucks.
Yeah, there is something about artists like Jimi Hendrix dying too early. It's like, you wonder,
what was next?
Yeah, what was next? But then part of it is like, you know, it all ends for all of us. And it's like walking away early is, it's kind of admirable. It's almost like I did a pretty good job.
Yeah.
I'm good with that. And especially the way he did, which is not telling anybody.
I know. 9 years, his best friends didn't even know. And in this world of like victimhood and I need clicks and I need people to love me, He got, you know, canceled and yelled at and in trouble, and he could have pulled that cancer card, and he never did. I mean, the integrity on this motherfucker.
Did you get a chance to interact with him? Like, what? How often did you meet him?
I met him once at the Comedy Cellar, and we chatted for 5 minutes, and then he went on and did the Letterman set that he did. He was running the Letterman set. And sweet guy, nice guy. I didn't know him that well, but, I mean, he's just brilliant. And I also love a brilliant guy who does stupid stuff. Mm-hmm. That's a fun little combo there. Like silly guys who are actually brilliant also. You know, like Louis C.K. is a brilliant comic, and he'll do a joke about farting on a kid. And you're like, that's great that he still finds farts funny, and he's also this comedic genius guy. Yeah. I like that.
And doesn't really acknowledge the genius.
Yeah.
I like smart people that are silly.
Yes, that's a good combo. Like you said, Elon is silly.
Yeah,
that's great.
Silly. Yeah.
Because we teach kids like, hey, put that down, stop that, quit cutting up, quit horsing around. But maybe that's some kind of sign of brilliance there.
Yeah. Being like childlike and silly is a kind of wisdom. I feel like those people are way wiser than the people that, no offense to me, wear a suit and take themselves way too seriously.
No, but you got a spark in you.
A little
bit. You got a little, the word? Not elf. Imp, a little imp in you. Give imp. That a goog. You know about imp?
Yeah,
mischievous. Let's look up, it's like a little.
Is that a Tolkien character? Imp.
Yeah, it might
be. An imp is a European mythological being similar to a fairy or a demon. You call me a fairy?
What?
Frequently. No, okay. Similar to a fairy or a demon.
Ooh,
I feel like that's a big leap.
Big leap. Yeah, that's not a great. Info bio there.
Frequently described in folklore and superstition, the word may perhaps derive from the term imp, spelled with a Y, used to denote a young grafted tree. Oh.
It's a little mischievous. You got a twinkle. You're the serious buttoned up guy, but there's a twinkle.
There's a twinkle. Wow.
And the audience can see the twinkle, and that's why you resonate, I think. I'm sorry.
Deep analysis by Mark Norman. Psychological analysis.